Hello all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 3rd March, Sunday. On the front page, there is no important news, so you can skip it. On page 8, you have below, the rule on reuse of cooking oil kicks in today. So this is what FSSAI, Food Safety and Standards Authority of India, has recently directed that food business operators who consume edible oil for frying in more than 50 liters a day, they should not reuse cooking oil more than 3 times. So, you know, this is to be implemented now. So, we have earlier seen about this RUCO program, repurposed used cooking oil that can be used to manufacture biodiesel. So, that is the program which has been launched. So, this is the detail regarding that, and this is very important. Then on page 13 below you have US seeks detail of misuse of F-16. So F-16s are fighter jets which Pakistan uses, and Pakistan had recently used them in the fight with the Indian Air Force jets, MiG-21s. So US is now seeking more information from Pakistan on the potential misuse of the American-made F-16 fighter jets it used against India in violation of the end user agreement. On international page, you have UNSC blacklists Osama Sir. So this is Hamza bin Laden, son of Osama bin Laden. He's seen as probable successor to Al-Qaeda leadership. So he has been blacklisted by UN Security Council. And besides, you have Canada launches extradition of Huawei executive to US. So Huawei is a Chinese organization in telecom sector, and it has a major presence in many countries, and it has been accused, or rather suspected. There is suspicion that it is used by China for spying. So the chief financial officer of Huawei actually was detained by Canadian authorities because of the case. The company has allegations, or US actually has suspicion that it violated the sanctions, US sanctions which are there on Iran. So she was arrested by Canadian authority, and now the extradition process has been initiated to extradite her to USA. On business page, you have RCEP nations to intensify talks to conclude trade pact. So this is regarding RCEP, 16 member grouping, that is Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership Group. So this comprises of ASEAN nations, Association of Southeast Asian Nations, plus 6 other nations with which ASEAN has FTAs. So this grouping includes India as well as China. So the 16 nation grouping has having negotiations going on for a trade pact which has been not been concluded yet. So now they are going to intensify talks to conclude the trade pact, the free trade agreement amongst them. On the last page you have SpaceX astronaut capsule launched on ISS mission. So this is International Space Station test mission which took place. So SpaceX astronaut capsule was launched, and the next challenge, it says, will be for docking at the space station. So now the Sunday's coverage in the Hindu newspaper has changed since last Sunday. So there is the regular main newspaper with the similar pages, and then the magazine as such contains various other sections, in which the important section for us is science and technology. So in the science and technology, the two pages, the first page has important news: cell lines to study familial Alzheimer's in a dish. So Alzheimer's disease we have discussed quite often, that is very important, so you should know at least about the disease. And this is targeting the H. pylori bacterium. So this is an indole based compound which has been found which could inhibit the bacterial enzyme selectively. So this has been a study which has been done by researchers from IIT Gandhinagar. And on the next page here you have multi-purpose piezoelectric nanogenerator fabricated. So what is piezoelectricity, you should know. So this piezoelectric nanogenerator has high energy conversion efficiency. This has been fabricated, means made, by the researchers from IIT Kharagpur. And this is Asia's oldest bamboo fossil. So scientists have come across a bamboo fossil in Northeast Asia, which is Asia's oldest as such bamboo fossil. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com in the current affairs section. So here, the daily current affairs is available, as well as current affairs on a monthly basis. Compilation will also be uploaded in a day or two, so you can avail that too. So that is it. Thank you.